Hey guys, welcome back to my channel and welcome to a story time, I think. I mean, maybe it's a rant-ish and story time, but we'll just call it a story time because this shit's funny as fook. Don't forget to follow my social medias and subscribe and like and comment, all of the above. So for this video, I'm gonna do So in this video, I'm gonna be doing my nails while telling you some stories of things that had happened and then what led up to this karma. So I will start with like in order, so like it'll go from like grade one to like when it happened. So the first one, grade one. So for this story, this girl don't even deserve a name. She just gets a letter for her name and it'll be R. So this R girl, she, like, her and I, we were like best friends. Like, it's one of those, you know, best friends that end up hating each other when they're an adult or whatever, just because of stupid bullshit. This one time, I think our moms had said yes to a sleepover or something like that. And, like, we found out at school somehow, or I think I was going home with her that day or something. I can't remember, but I just remember us both being really excited. But, like, she was way more excited than I was. And she literally just like hugged me so hard that like my arm started to like physically hurt, and then she let go, and then like my skin's like really really sensitive, so like bruises showed up like almost immediately, and I was like, oh. And I was crying because I was like 6 years old, and I was like, dude, why are you squeezing me this hard? I made such a huge scene about it. I was like, this hoe, like I didn't say that, but I was like, you fucking squeezed me so hard. Like I was just like trying to make her look bad at that point. Another time in grade one, like I was also friends with her sister as well. Her sister was like a year or two older than us. I remember I got this birthday gift from my mom's friend, and it was a charm bracelet. And I was like 7 years old, so like I liked to wear jewelry a bit, you know? It was such a nice bracelet, you know? Like it was so cute, had little shoes and flowers and sunglasses as charms and things like that. And then I remember one day I brought it to school because I was like, oh, this is really cool. I love it so much, right? I'm gonna wear it all the time. I go to school and then her sister sees that I'm wearing it, and then she's like, oh, this is so cool. Can I wear it? Like, can I have it for the night or whatever? I was like, yeah, sure. Like, at this time, I didn't know about anything like how you shouldn't trust everybody that you meet. So, like, I was like, yeah, sure. Like, just give it back to me the next day, you know? Like, I wanna wear it. The next day, when she comes back to school, she's like cartwheeling to school. Like, I can see her cartwheeling. And then she comes in, and then I'm asking her where my thing is, right? Like, I'm asking her where my bracelet is. And then she's like tripping out. She's like, oh my God, I don't know where it is. Oh my God, I think I lost it on the way here. And I'm like, oh, really? I was kind of sad because, like, I didn't even get to wear it that long myself. And then she just like lost it on the way over there. And I'm like, why would you start doing cartwheels knowing you had something in your pocket? Like, I just don't understand. Come on now. So, grade two, I would always like go to her house and like sleep over and things like that. So it would always be like me, R, her sister, and then her sister's friend. And this time it was all four of us, and we all decided to like play together. Like, you know, just like dress up stuff and nails and makeup, you know, girly shit, right? And I remember we were all having a good time. Like, we were all just like chilling out and like doing each other's nails and things like that, and like doing each other's makeup and things. And then R just got so upset out of nowhere. She just like tripped out, and she was just so sad, right? And like, she didn't explain why she was upset, but she just like left the room, and we're like, okay, peace out, right? So I like continued to hang out with her sister and her friend, right? And then all of a sudden, her mom calls us down like to the main floor, right? Because we're upstairs, right? And her mom calls all of us down, and then she starts like bitching at us about leaving R out of the group or whatever. We're like, what are you talking about? And then R was like crying her eyes out. She was just like, they're taking all of my makeup and using it without me, and just like using all of my stuff and not even using her sister's stuff. And like, I was just like, this is the dumbest thing you've ever cried about. Like, you just got jealous that I was hanging out with your sister. Like, we could have hung out just you and me, but like,
You wanted to hang out with your sister too and her friend, so why are you trying to blame it all on me?
So the other thing was also, because like this wasn't the same day, but like a different, it was still in grade two. And I remember we were just talking about earrings and things like that. Like she had earrings, so like she could just choose whatever she wanted. But like my earrings were pierced, but they had like closed up a bit. So like they weren't fully closed, but they weren't like fully through, you know. And she was like, oh, let's put some earrings on you, like you have the holes, like why not just like force it through, right? And like without even me saying anything, she just like puts it through my ear and like stabs it through my ear, and then like my ears are just bleeding, and she did it on both ears, and then my ears are just bleeding, right? But like I'm in pain, but I'm also happy because like I'm like 7 years old, and I'm just like, I always wanted to try those dangly earrings, you know, because like I could never have them. And then, like, because my skin is too sensitive, right? So, she just, like, stabbed it through my ear. And then I'm just, like, walking around with blood down, dripping down my face on both sides. And then she's like, oh, shit. And I'm like, well, that's your fault. That was an experience. Okay, so, like, we didn't have class together for grade 3 and 4. And then she moved to a different school for grade 5 and 6. So, like, might be a bit scattered. So if we're gonna move to grade 4, because I didn't hang out with her in grade 3. So grade 4, I was hanging out with her sister, because her sister was in my class, because like it was one of those like 4 or 5 classes, like you have both grades in one class together, if that makes sense. And her sister happened to be in my class, and then she was actually in the next class over, and then I just started hanging out with her sister, right? Because like obviously I know her already, so why wouldn't I go to people I already knew? So after her and I like start become really close, we start hanging out like all the time. Like it's every single day, every single lunch hour, like any chance that we see each other, we're like hanging out, you know? So eventually she like, we started making this pact where like we wouldn't hang out with anybody else except for each other. And like, if one of us isn't there, we just like hang out by ourselves or whatever until the other person gets there or like next day, you know? And I remember one time she told me that she was going to be there late for lunch or something, because she went home for lunch and I always had to stay at school. And I remember she was taking a long time getting to the school, and like the lunch hour was almost over. And I was like, well, I'm going to enjoy my lunch hour of the day. Like, why would I just like waste an hour just to like meet up with somebody that might not even come on time, right? So and also another friend had asked me to hang out anyway. So like I remember I was sitting on the field, right? And I was just waiting for our sister, right? And another kid comes up to me and they're like, hey, do you want to hang out or whatever? I was like, yeah, sure. Like my friend isn't on their way, like isn't here yet. So why not just go hang out till they come here, like till they get here, right? We went to go play. We were just having a good time and not even thinking about my friend, right? Or like our sister. And all of a sudden, while I'm on the monkey bars, I just hear our sister come over, and she's just like, what are you doing? I thought that you were gonna wait for me. And then I'm like, I'm sorry, like I was asked to hang out with them, so like I wasn't gonna say no if like you weren't here. And then she got so mad and she was just like, okay, well we're not friends anymore. And I was like, okay. And then like I literally felt so sad, because like I was really a lonely child, so like I literally like chased after her, and then I was like trying to make it up to her and like be her friend or whatever. And then she's like, no, I'm done. And I was like, okay. And then kind of just stopped hanging out from there, to be honest. Okay, so she wasn't at my school for grade 5 and grade 6, so we'll just skip to grade 7, because we went to the same junior high and high school. So for the grade 7 ones, there's like 5 here so that I remember clear as day. So for the first one, it says, I just want to go in order though. Okay, I don't really remember exactly the order these were in, because they were all like same time frame, sort of, if you know what I mean. So I'll just like go by the little stories and then tell you the how they all led up to that. I just need to fix that. So like this one point, I don't know why people think that I'm scared of spiders, but I'm not scared of spiders. And I remember this hoe, she tried to like put a dead spider in our locker, because we shared a locker, because of another hoe.
another hoe kicked me out of her locker, and then this R hoe let me in her locker, but then she started accusing me of shit and doing shit to herself, and then like accusing me, and then I ended up leaving her and then getting my own locker anyways. That's a little mini tea. I thought that like putting a spider in our locker, a dead spider, like a daddy long leg, would scare the shit out of me if I opened up the locker and it fell out or whatever. And that plan did not work out for them at all, because I wasn't scared for shit. The next one, so like, I remember this one time, you know when you're just like leaning down on your knees and like you're talking to somebody when you're at their desk, right? And like your legs are just kind of like laid out, so, but they're not like blocking the whole way, they're just like halfway, you know? So I remember this hoe, she like came over to where I was like kneeled down talking to somebody, right? And then all of a sudden she just like stepped so hardcore on my calf, like I literally almost felt it break. Like that's how she put all of her weight on it, right? And like I tripped out, right? But like I didn't do shit, cause like I'm smart enough to not like fight people on school property, cause like, you know, there's cameras everywhere, and I'm like not really about to get charged. Like I know that I'd be a kid, but like I know her family would go after my family. Like it goes deeper than that, you know, like. She wouldn't just try to, like, fuck with me. She'd try to fuck with my whole family, you know? So, like, I wasn't about to let that happen. So, I just let that slide or whatever, you know? And then another time, she pushed me out of my chair. Like, just went up to me and, like, pushed me on, like, from my chest. And, like, pushed me out of my chair. And I fell to the ground, right? And, like, she did that because she thought that I pushed her when we were both walking through the doorway to get into the classroom, and like even though we were both just trying to squish through at the same time and we both had big backpacks, and like she just made it over dramatic. The teacher gave me an incident report and I was like, dude, I didn't do shit. Like for once I didn't start anything, and then I still get a fucking incident report. Like this school is actually messed up. I hated it so much. I probably had, like, the most incident reports in, like, 1 year. Like, I had, like, 10 or, like, 9 at least. Anyway, so back to my story. I remember this one other time. She and I, we were in the cafeteria. And we were sitting together. I think we were with, like, one other friend. And her sister and her sister's friends were, like, the table across from us. Like, beside our table. And they could clearly see us directly, so like a girl saw this, like one of our sister's friends saw the entire thing happen. R was sitting with me, and then she went to get up to do something or to go leave, or I don't remember, she went to go do something, and she got up with her little fruit cup thing, and then she just dumped it on my head in front of everyone and like laughed in my face and then walked out of the cafeteria. And another time where like or my high school was attached to a swimming pool and like a leisure center, so people of any age just goes into that water pool thing, right? And they always had these nights called teen night, so like anyone from ages like 13 to 18 could go, and they just like basically have a pool party indoors, right? And all the music and stuff like that and people doing shit, right? And then I remember one time I went there, and then it was R, her sister, and then her sister's friend. And like, I don't remember how it happened, but I remember one of R's sister's friend, because R's sister's friend forgot something. And then R just like gave her my dry clothes, and then she went out into the pool. She didn't have a swimsuit. I just like walked home with soaking wet clothes, because like a soaking wet swimsuit, because she gave my clothes to her, and I had nothing else. It gets better. R would always try to, like, threaten to fight me and things like that, but, like, it never actually happened because, you know, she'd just get her ass whooped anyways. Grade 9, I remember one time, this specific time, I can't remember exactly how it happened, but this hoe, she somehow managed to, like, slap me in the face like multiple times. Like, she would just stand in front of me and just, like, start smacking me, right? And, like, I didn't do anything because I definitely wasn't trying to, like, get suspended. Like, at this point in my life, I was more scared of my mom than anyone else. Like, I just didn't want to get suspended because I knew that my mom would whoop my ass even more if she found out that, like, I got suspended over something stupid, right? I let this bullshit happen, right? I remember it all leads up to, like, this one moment. So, all this shit happens, right? Like, she's just a, like, she just talks shit about me all the time, right? And I remember this one specific time. This is where the karma comes in. So, this one time, it's like me and like three other boys that we're walking with, and then her, right? And we're all like walking home together and stuff like that. And I don't know why this hoe decides to like tag along, but like she did anyways. So she was walking behind us, like, so it was me, two of the guy friends in front, and then it was her and then another guy friend, but walking behind us, right? And she, I overhear her talking about like how she can like beat me up and things like that, how she's gonna do it like right now, you know? So like she, all of a sudden I just like feel some sort of like weight on my back. Like I didn't really understand what was happening at the beginning. And then I was like, wait, what the fuck, right? And then like I see her arms trying to like hold on to my neck, you know, trying to choke me, right? So like I feel this and I'm like, what the fuck? Like, get the fuck off me. Like, I still didn't really understand what was happening at the right when it first happened. But then, like, as soon as I flipped her over, like, this hoe went over my shoulder and smashed into the pavement. Like, like her ass and tailbone hit that pavement so hard. And, like, I could see that she hit her elbows and shit on the way down, too. So, like, she just, like, smashed into the ground, right? And then she got up and, like, everybody was laughing in her face, right? And then she, like, gets up and then she walks away and then she starts walking again with us, but like still behind me and all like the other dudes, right? And then she's still with that other dude, right? And then we walk up like a block further and then she tries it again, right? So like the second time I'm like ready for it, you know? So like as soon as I fucking felt that hoe grab me, I bent over and I grabbed her so hard and I whipped her so hard into the cement that she never tried to fight me ever again. She didn't talk shit to my face ever again. Like, she never even tried to fight me or do anything. Like, she knew that I wasn't about to play. And I really chose my fight there, you know, because, like, I could have beat the shit out of her. Like, I could have kicked her in the face and, like, really, like, broke her jaw and shit when she was on the ground. But, like, I really don't want to get charged. Like, you can still go to juvie. So, like, I'm not about to have a charge as a kid that leads into an out. Look at Michael Bisping. Like, he literally has problems traveling to this day because he was in prison for fighting in the streets. So, it's like, you really got to pick your battles, you know? Like, I'm not about to play with, like, the law and shit like that. But, like, if somebody really trying to attack me, they're going to get it, you know? So, this hoe fucked with a lot of other girls as well. Like, a lot of my friends, they had their experiences with her as well. That was, might not be like a super crazy karma got you type thing, like a real, like, you know, ass biter, but like it was good enough for me because she never tried ever again to fight me in person. Like, she never threatened me, she never like cyberbullied me, nothing like that. And like, she tried to talk shit in high school, like, because this was grade 9, right? So, like, she tried to talk shit when we were in high school, but, like, everybody knew that, like, she was a bitch anyways. Like, nobody fucking liked her anyways. So, like, nobody would take her word for anything. And they all knew that I beat her ass. So, like, it was just a joke, you know? Like, she was literally the joke of the whole school. So, she ain't popular now. So, like, was all that bitchiness really worth it? So, do you want to see my nails? Okay, let me finish. Hold on. They're not perfect, but they're all right for me. So here's the purple, and then here's the blue. So that is my nails for the day, and I hope you guys enjoyed this story time. I mean, I thought it was pretty good. You know, karma got her. You know, she really did deserve it. I mean, sometimes I think she deserved a bit more. But that is it for me today. I hope you enjoyed the story, and I'm sorry if it's really long, but yeah, and I hope you have a good day, and like, comment, subscribe, follow all my shit, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.